Are diamonds really a girl's best friend? I like to think so. I've been a jewelry collector since I was young, always playing dress up in my mother's favorite jewels and getting overly excited when I received a new piece to mark the most special occasions and milestones. Much like my love of vintage and antique items, my jewelry obsession started with my great-grandmother. Every time I'd go to visit, she'd show me her incredible costume jewelry collection and tell me stories about each piece. She even gave me a few that I still have today. Jewelry has a unique way of connecting you with those that you love and the memories you share. It's not only beautiful to look at and wear, but it's quite sentimental as it often reminds you of a person, place, or special memory in time. Today, I'm sharing my jewelry collection with you, including some of my favorite vintage, costume, and fine jewelry pieces, along with how I organize each one. We're going to take it from this to this. Let's begin! Gorgeous pink jewelry box is from Wolf 1834, and the design was inspired by the 1950s. It's called the Caroline, and this is in the size large. It showcases a top handle, gold hardware, mirror, and four organizational levels with 19 compartments, four ring rolls, and a secret compartment. It also comes with an adorable travel case so that you can take your favorite jewels with you anywhere you go, and features Luster Lock to help prevent tarnishing for up to 35 years. And of course, the soft blush pink color and elegant quilting detail are to die for. On the top level, I have a variety of rings and earrings along with some of my special designer pieces. The second level houses a lot of my fine jewelry, including many of my dainty necklaces and bracelets. The third level includes more earrings, brooches, and statement necklaces, bracelets, and watches. The bottom level has a few of my vintage pieces, statement necklaces, and bangles. I'm going to show you a few of my favorite pieces right now. These are my vintage Chanel earrings, and I believe they're from the 1990s. They are so gorgeous and sparkly in person. And these are another vintage Chanel clip-on earring, and I believe these are from the late 70s or early 80s. And this is my Chanel brooch. I love the pearl details. I'm definitely a pearl girl. This was a ring that I got from my very first fashion show at my very first fashion week. It is such a special piece. The designer actually created it. And I don't have many statement rings, but I really love this one. It's a flower, of course, and I just think it is absolutely beautiful. And this is another statement set that I got from the Bauble Bar headquarters when I visited in New York. These are a few of my silver rings. I don't have too much silver in my jewelry collection. I'm definitely more of a rose gold or yellow gold kind of girl, but I think that these are absolutely beautiful. I love the diamond band, the bow, and the last one is my wedding ring and engagement ring. My husband picked them out, and they are by far my favorite pieces of jewelry. These are two of my favorite rings from Angara. They have the most beautiful gemstones. The first one is aquamarine, and the second one is morganite. I think that they look like princess rings. They're so beautiful. And these are vintage rings. One of them I picked up from the local antique store, and the second one is an heirloom. And this is one of my favorite ring sets from Gorgiana. I love it so much that I actually have a second set. These are a few of my other favorites. As you will see, I have a big love of florals, and that definitely shows through my jewelry collection. I have lots of floral jewelry, and I also really love gemstones. This is my favorite pair of clip-on earrings. They are pearls in the shape of a flower, and they are just so elegant and gorgeous. This is another pair of clip-ons, and I love the Art Deco style. It reminds me of the Great Gatsby. And these are such a fun and sparkly pair of statement earrings. The color is so beautiful. These are a few of my favorite fine jewelry bracelets. I have a mix of silver, gold, and rose quartz. And these are some of my fancy bracelets. The tennis bracelet with the emeralds and diamonds was an heirloom from either my mother or my great-grandmother. And of course, initial necklaces are super popular now. I have a new one and an old one. So the L is actually a newer one that I just got. And the E is one that I got as a gift when I was younger. This is a vintage necklace that was given to me by my great-grandmother. It's a mother of pearl with floral detailing. These are some of my fine jewelry necklaces. They have different types of diamonds, and the silver one is actually a locket that was inspired by one of my favorite movies, Beauty and the Beast. This is one of my very favorite statement necklaces. I love the florals and the colors so much. It reminds me of springtime. These are two of my fancy watches. The one with the stars is actually from Kate Spade, and it makes me feel like a princess every time I wear it. These are my statement bracelets, and I've gotten a lot of wear out of these over the years. They're some of my very favorites. This is a newer piece from Una de 50, and I actually shared it in my girly girl clothing haul. It is so beautiful. I think these clip-on earrings are so much fun. I am obsessed with them. They remind me of the 1960s. This is a choker from a brand called Monet, and I believe it's from the 1980s. These are a few of my favorite brooches that I love to accessorize with. And these are a few of my favorite watches. I love the diamond detailing, the soft color palette, and the floral band of the Kate Spade watch. This necklace was actually sent to me by a follower a few years ago. It is so beautiful. She said it's vintage and she found it in thrift store, and I love it so much. It reminds me of Princess Kate. This is one of my all-time favorite necklaces. It's from Juicy Couture years and years ago, and I've worn it so much, but oh my gosh, I just love it. And this is another favorite. You've probably seen this in a ton of my flatlays if you follow me on Instagram. It is so beautiful, and the medallion is actually from France. This is another vintage item from my great-grandmother, and it is one of my prized possessions. This is a Givenchy pearl necklace with a snake clasp, and I've never seen anything else like it. This is also another pearl necklace from my great-grandmother, and I believe it's from the 1960s or 70s. This is another floral necklace from Juicy Couture, and I think it is the cutest thing. These are two of my favorite bangles, so of course I have it in gold and rose gold. They're both from Kate Spade, and they're so sparkly. And these are a few of my favorite statement bangles. Of course, I have a bow and some jewels and florals. This is a travel case, also from Wolf 1834. It has a beautiful emerald velvet with floral embroidery. The interior includes three compartments, ring rolls, and a mirror. It's about the size of a clutch, and the size is perfect for travel. For now, it just holds a few bracelets, rings, a hair clip, and a brooch. And this is the smaller travel case that comes with the large jewelry box. It's petite, so it can easily fit anywhere. I recommend it for smaller items like these dainty rings and necklaces. Since I have an abundance of jewelry, I have a few other storage options on my dresser. This vintage tray holds a couple of my floral statement necklaces, a pair of clip-on earrings, and a multi-strand pearl choker. This necklace bar includes a lot of my fun and colorful statement necklaces. This bracelet bar holds a lot of my bangles. This three-tier tray houses my whimsical statement earrings that include tons of florals and fun designs like ice cream cones. This vintage tray includes all of my long pendants and tassel necklaces. This bracelet bar holds some of my watches. This necklace bar holds some of my dainty necklaces. And this necklace bar includes all of my neutral statement necklaces. I hope you enjoy getting a peek into my jewelry collection and seeing how I organize it all. Let me know what your favorite jewelry type is in a comment below, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe so you don't miss out on any future videos. For more girly content and to see more of my everyday life, make sure you check out my blog, lizzieandlace.com, and Instagram, @lizzieandlace. Thank you so much for joining me. Bye!